can do in roll 20.
Depending if my internet decides to be nice.
Okay, actually...
My voice comes through fine, right?
Yeah, your voice is fine.
We'll see. Okay. We'll see.
Oh, hey, speaking of boyfriend...
Okay, actually...
My voice comes through fine.
Okay.
Sorry, him and I have been having a rough patch recently because of my work. We lost 2 full-time cooks within a week, so I'm working overtime as a part-time employee. Mm. I'm working over 40 hours, and I'm going to shoot myself.
But I have delicious blueberries, so I'm not going to shoot myself.
My leg itches like fuck. Siri, why didn't you tell me how much of an idiot I was?
I don't know.
Oh. I thought you loved me.
Only sometimes.
I'm heartbroken now.
Only when it's convenient.
You only love me when it's convenient. That sounds like everyone else in my life.
Sounds like me with me.
No Revlobot?
Revlobot is dead. I hate Revlobot.
Why is Revlobot dead?
R.I.P. R.I.P. Revlo.
I need to rework my entire reward system because it was based on Minecraft. And I hate Minecraft now.
I thought you never liked Minecraft because Minecraft is stupid.
I never did like Minecraft. That's the running joke with everyone who streams Minecraft. We never liked Minecraft, but we do it because it gets views.
I loved it. Still do like it.
So do I, but I hate it. I like it, but I hate it, you know?
That tasted funny.
Well.
You wanna know what we should do?
Huh.
One of these nights that I don't try and kill myself, we should play Terraria.
Oh. I mean, Terraria is okay.
We need to all play Lasers and Feelings.
I don't think that...
But since Siri got it for me, I haven't been able to play recently, so I feel bad. And I want to play it. And I wanted to get the achievements because I'm kind of an achievement whore.
Alex, how are you enjoying NBA 2K16?
Can't install it out of bandwidth.
Oh. Lovely.
RIP.
That being said, NBA is also like 60 gigs, so it'll probably take me a while, regardless of bandwidth.
Oh, right. You're in Eskimoville.
That's right. Alaska. Oh, my God.
Speaking of Alaska, Graham's fucking, what's the word I'm looking for? His Wii and his fucking... DVR, both were fucking up. The only channel that we could get was Animal Planet. And it was some stupid, like, veteran lady in Alaska bullshit that we were, like, forced to endure for, like, 2 hours.
Oh, man. There's a whole bunch of those.
You know what show I'm talking
fucking...
about, right?
Probably. Well, I mean, they're kind of all the stupid reality, Alaskan wilderness shows kind of blend together after a while.
It was veteran shit, like veterinary shit.
Oh.
Like animals.
No, I've never heard of that one, actually.
And she's like, I'm gonna go to this place so we can get these animals attention. It's just like, I just wanna fucking watch Wipeout or something. I'm bored of this. Can we go back to watching children kill each other in the Hunger Games? Because that's more entertaining than this.
Fuck, I was gonna say something.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well.
So, are you, like, giving the game away for free? I saw that post on Facebook. What's going on with that?
So I have a few games to give away. Right, I need to put giveaway in the title so we can actually get fucking viewers.
Yeah, oh my God, whore that out.
What games are you gonna give away? Because I'm tempted to try.
No, you
giveaway
can't
is for
try.
Viewers only.
Lame.
I'll put up Bad Rats.
I'll put there up Shower go. With Your Dad Simulator again.
Let me see if I still have any Steam keys.
Let's see. We have Mafia 2, Freedom Force versus the Third Reich, The Bureau, XCOM Declassified, and Railroad Tycoon 3.
Ew.
Railroad
Tycoon. Like 9 of those 10, like 9 out of 10 ratio for goodness in those games.
Let's see. Steam.
I have not played Railroad Tycoon.
I don't have any Steam keys, which is good.
I thought I had Steam keys. Oh, there they are. There's my 10.
Wait, we leveled up, didn't we?
I have,
when did we hit level 3?
We hit level 3?
Yeah.
Hang on, let me consult. Yeah, okay, yeah, we did. Never mind.
So let me see. Oh, I may or may not have Force Unleashed 1 and 2. I don't remember, so...
Cody, did your character sheet not save again?
What?
I mean, my character sheet's made, but I don't know if my shit's set up for level 3 or not. Cody, I think so.
Do you think I really know?
Yeah, I should be, because I'm at 8 hit points out of 27.
Yeah,
oh, you're look. Level 3.
Because, you know, I died like 3 times.
It sort of saved. It says level 3, but nothing's updated. what would my hit points go up to? What did I go up to?
Ah, oh, son of a bitch.
Because I rolled. I went a plus 8, I think. Because I rolled decent.
You really need to get a better PDF viewer.
No. It's just because I don't save.
Do you not have it so where you try to exit out, it doesn't try to tell you, oh, hey, you need to fucking save this, you idiot?
Oh, no, I just shut my computer off. I don't do any of that stuff.
Wow, like, mine holds up. If I don't save something, I try to turn my computer off, it asks me if I want to save it before it shuts down.
Oh, yeah, I just click yeah, it's
mine
fine.
Does do that. God, it knows Cody well enough that he doesn't give a shit.
Oh, when I do that, I'm so tired. I'm just like, I don't fucking care. We'll just worry about it next weekend.
3 levels from now. Ah, fuck it. I don't need to go past level 3.
So I'm at 23. That
sounds like some bullshit I would do.
That works. And you have the thing, don't you?
What thing?
Oh, the thing.
Oh, yeah, the thing.
The book?
Don't worry about it.
I better know the fucking capital, Madrid.
Blah, 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 blah. You know what? That's fine. I don't... Yeah. Cutting action. I have a dagger, too, but that's fine. Okay, so where the hell is Josh? What is he doing?
He might still be sleeping.
Doing your mom.
Does anybody have his number?
Might? I don't think I do.
I only have Tim's number.
Who takes a nap at fucking midnight?
He got off work at 7.
Power napped a while ago.
Yeah, he got off work at 7 and then decided to take a nap. To be fair, I did tell him we were starting like 1:30 a.m. EST. So I might be waiting until the last minute. So we have lots of pre-stream time for whatever bullshit we need to talk about after the 2 weeks.
Okay. Yeah.
Well,
so
we can't do next week. I work over 40 hours at my part-time job, and Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, I work all day. It's tax-free weekend, and we have free root beer floats Saturday, 2 to close.
I'm coming.
I'm going to kill myself.
We're all going there.
On my way.
Yeah, and okay, so you're driving over 100 miles?
I'm going to have to swim the first 10, but that's fine.
Tax-free is tax-free, man.
Tax-free root beer floats are always worth it.
No, they're free. Saturday, 2 p.m. to 2 p.m.
I'm on my way right now.
Dude, road trip right now. I'll pick up Cody.
Oh, let's do it.
Right, I'll swim down to mainland USA. Give me a minute.
It'll be a little cold.
Just a little cold.
Buys blueberries to stop eating junk food all the time. Eats all of the blueberries in one sitting.
I do that whenever I buy fucking berries. It's gone instantly.
Let's see if anybody's in chat. Not a fucking soul.
No.
That's okay. We don't
can't. I can't Twitch.
Alright, let's try this beer, huh?
Alright.
Oh, gosh.
Let me know how shitty it tastes.
Speaking of alcohol, so... One time when I was in a hospital, I was visiting my niece's mother, who is not, like, in any way, like, a sister-in-law or anything. Just, she was a girl that my brother had a baby with. And,
children.
There, at the hospital, there was this blackberry pie, and that shit tasted fermented.
I can just imagine the inside is just pure fucking liquid blue blackberry.
It was. It was fucking liquid.
And I was drinking straight from the pie.
Yeah. Like, it was leaking all over the plate and shit, too. Like, just this goop. And, like, I ate some of it, and I'm like, this doesn't taste good. But I have to be sure that it doesn't taste good, so I ate a little bit more of it. And I'm pretty sure I threw up. Pretty sure.
Not exactly sure.
You can't remember he threw up so hard.
I can't remember. I was so drunk.
He was so fermented.
It's just instant alcohol poisoning from it.
I got an update on the beer.
Does it taste sour?
It's like a fucking warhead.
Ooh.
It's like, I mean, it's weird. It's not bitter. It's not hoppy or anything. And it smells like beer. It tastes kind of like beer. But it's like, then I drink it, and all of a sudden my cheeks are like, what the fuck's happening?
What's that?
Wow. So if you guys ever get a chance to try a sour, go for it.
I can't stand the taste of normal alcohol.
Oh, yeah. I mean, and plus you're not old enough, so don't underage drink. In fact, the only one that can try it is Tim, so bottoms up.
Yeah, so if any of you guys ever get a chance, and by that I mean one person.
Oh, man, it's so fucking weird. I don't even know what's going on. This is...
I don't drink often enough to experiment. Like, everything I drink is an experiment.
Yeah, no, I don't. I mean, I don't really drink all that much. I just drink beer or cider. And that's really it. But this is, you know what? I'm going to drink this.
I need to find a beer that I enjoy.
I don't know why alcohol's appealing.
Because it gets you fucked up.
That's my issue, though. I know what it does to people. I live with one.
Well, different types of people are different types of drunks.
I know.
Yeah, I haven't been drunk.
None of the ones I've experienced have been good.
Cody turns into a pure party animal.
No.
I would love to see that.
Suddenly actually, old man no more.
As with anything, I just fall asleep.
Does cocaine falls asleep.
The last time I got kind of drunk was when my wife and I lived in our apartment. We watched QVC.
Oh, hardcore night.
Yeah.
QVC?
Yeah, QVC. We just watched it for a couple hours. You know, it's a shopping network.
That sounded a lot better when you didn't say what it was.
Yeah. Totally watched
it. So you were watching it.
No, we straight up watching Dooney and Burke bags. They were beautiful.
Why?
Well, for one,
At least I have some standards in what I watch.
And what?
At least I have some standards in what I watch.
I mean, so, it was late at night. We ordered out, and I decided to have a couple of beers. And then we watched QVC because that's what adults do.
It's okay. My boyfriend and his dad were going furniture shopping for the apartment he's getting with his roommates because they're all going to the same fucking college. And, like, he's asking his dad questions, and his dad's just like, I don't know, your mother did all this. He's like, women just seem to be better at interior decorating anyway. And, when he was telling me this, I look at him. I'm like, he's not wrong. He's really not. Because I kind of enjoy it, but at the same time, it's like, why the fuck did he say that?
May or may not have started texting.
Yeah, text him. I have cookies. Here we go.
You should send me some cookies.
Dude, I got these, just these M&M cookies. And it's probably the best decision I've ever made in my life.
These are just like Market Pantry, Target brand cookies.
Oh, yeah. Like, the little ones that come with this, like, plastic thing in the bottom. And there are like 50 of the damn things.
Yeah. That's the one.
I know that life.
Some vanilla ice cream and have some cupcake. I'm playing a game on my phone where I have to run like the best cafe ever, and I don't know why, but it's super entertaining.
Okay, so, Cody, you had a Pokemon Go thing you wanted to talk about.
Oh, it's not.
What team are you?
I'm Valor.
Kill yourself.
Dizzity damn.
We'll see.
But
it wasn't Team Valor. I'm not really ranting. I haven't really had any bad experiences with Pokemon Go.
Well, fine.
I mean, I live in a college town. Everyone's playing it. But I had an incident at work on Friday, right?
Right.
So I work in customer service, sort of weirdly, and I talk to people on the phone. I talk to people on the internet. I do all sorts of weird stuff. So this lady calls in, right? Now, a little bit of background about my company. We sell promotional products. People buy our products. They put their logos on these products to market. So this lady wants a bag, right? It's a very specific type of bag. Very specific type of material, like recycled vegetable matter. I don't know. It's awful. And so for the past 2 weeks, this lady has been in our phone queue. Like, oh, I want this bag. Oh, I want that bag. I'm going to order this bag. I'm going to cancel this order. I'm going to do this with this order. Right? Big old fucking production. And then eventually we send her out some samples of these bags, right? Let her just see them for herself. She finally makes a decision. And guess what? Her artwork won't work on the bag. So she starts flipping her shit. She's just like, I was like, I sent the artwork to the factory. They said no. And I was like, ma'am, I'm so sorry. I can't do anything. She's like, I know you can do it. You're lying to me. And I'm like, no, I'm not. Listen, I told her I would get to the factory on Monday. There's nothing I can do. She started, like, fucking freaking out. No matter how many times I repeated the same thing. I'm sorry, there's nothing I can do. There's nothing I can do. For an hour, this lady fucking comes at me. And she's just, like, you know, berating the company, calling me a liar, saying all sorts of terrible shit. And then I'm just shaking. I'm mad. I can't get her off the phone. Nothing I can say gets her off the phone. I'm just, like, so mad. But I can't do anything because I'm customer service.
Dude, I know, right?
And it's like, I've never gotten that mad at somebody. By the time I got done, I'm going to tell my boss on Monday. I'm like, she's never allowed to talk to me again. She's never allowed. Like, I closed her for business. She's never allowed to work with us again. It's the worst person ever. So...
Fuck so that person.
So if you ever work with Jack and Jill of America, fuck them.
Alright, got it. Okay, yeah. I'm going to go dump these blueberries back in the fridge before I get really, really fat off of them.
Can't get fat off blueberries.
Bitch, I'll try.
It's okay. My boss likes it when I work drive-through because I give all the customers who ask really stupid-ass questions attitudes, and I'm so sarcastic with them. And see, basically, I'm just that. A general smartass. Thing is, he tells me I'm not allowed to do it, but doesn't do anything to stop me.
Oh, it's kind of like, it was weird. It's like Big Brother at my work. We got cameras and everything, and... You know, it's not crazy. I work in a loosey-goosey type environment. Hell, they had a fucking keg, like a fridge full of beer that they let us have. I could have drank while working. I mean, not a lot, but some. Shit. But, you know, I get free food, all sorts of shit. But, you know, I just gotta smile and wave.
I'm back.
Yeah.
Oh, dog, why did you open my door? I'm going away for a second.
So is Josh just, are we just gonna like, just, you know?
We're just gonna chill until he shows up.
Or not, until he shows.
I just love annoying the hell out of people. I mean, because that's kind of what I do at work. I mean, like, they'll ask me a question. Like, the two-piece Fishmore is our L5, and they're like, what's the two-piece Fishmore? And I say the L5, and they're like, well, what's the L5? What's the fucking two-piece Fishmore? Fuck. Damn.
Bless you.
Then you literally just asked what it was.
Ooh, my desk is nice and cool where the blueberries were.
Is Alex still alive?
Is someone still alive?
Alex, is your mic muted, Alex? Did you die, Alex? Alex.
I hope he died.
Oh.
Yeah, okay, we're 9.
Oh, God.
Is that beer getting to you?
Yeah. Super weird. Super, super weird.
If Josh isn't back by fucking 1:45, I'm DMing this shit.
We'll just play Lasers and Feelings.
I don't even know how to even start to do that. You don't have to have it. It's another kind of tabletop thing, and the rules are really simple. Damn it, Josh, and your power napping.
Well, if he doesn't play, we could play Terraria or that or just something.
Yeah, well, something.
I mean, like, fuck, I didn't cut my date early with my boyfriend for nothing. Because, you know, I've seen him 5 times this fucking summer.
Josh. 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 I'm assuming when he reads this, he'll read it in the voice I was making.
I was gonna say, like, are you yelling at him?
I'm typing at him very incoherently.
I wonder if any of these Steam keys I have still work.
Maybe.
I was gonna make a joke and say, send them to me and try it.
Yeah, no.
Send them to me and try it. I don't have enough games. Totally not sitting.
Bitch, you have more games than I do.
I know.
I have. How do you find out how many you have?
If you
go to your Steam and then you hit games.
Hover over your library tab on Steam, and it'll tell you.
Oh, I have 148.
Suck it, 158.
I have 65.
And I only play like 10.
Yeah, I have quality. One of the main games I play is not even on Steam. Well, one of the games is on Steam, but not the one I play.
Minecraft?
No, World of Mixed Martial Arts. It's a text-based MMA simulator.
You told me about that.
Yeah, it's great. I live for it. I breathe it.
I don't understand how that's a thing.
It all started because the guy made a really, really stripped down version of this game, but for wrestling. And I used to just spend hours like creating shows and storylines and creating characters and doing all sorts of things that my sweet teenage fantasy could come up with, like, oh, this guy's gonna be champion. And then eventually, you know, got lost in time, I forgot about it. And then I found out that he made this game. I'm like, oh my god. And I've played it since the second one, and now it's on the fourth one. I'm like, so good.
When was it made?
I mean, the one I'm playing last year.
Oh, wow.
But so the original one, like, 2010.
So he hasn't invented graphics yet.
Graphics?
I mean, they're like, the characters are like 3D rendered models, but I mean, it's mostly all text-based.
Okay.
And I don't like to play the pictures anyways, because it lags it.
How does that lag a text-based game?
It just does.
How poorly optimized is your game when that happens?
Well, because there's just so much. I mean, it's just so much data. So much. I mean, we're talking like 4,000 fighters and companies, all sorts of different. Like,
Dota 2 now has a VR function.
Yeah, I heard about that.
I don't know how I feel about this.
Guys, we should. Too bad we all can't starve together.
Yeah.
Dude, I wish I had that game so bad.
Oh, I know.
I finally got Don't Starve Standalone.
I have all of the DLC as well.
So do I.
Do you like Shipwrecked?
I haven't played to that point yet. I've played Don't Starve Together like twice with Andrew, and we survived until like the very first few days of winter and then died.
Yeah.
Classic.
Oh. Oh, and my MMA game is multiplayer. We can
how?
Take because you can take turns like in a hot seat. Yeah.
None of us have Jackbox games, do we?
What was that?
Oh, like the party games?
Yeah, Jackbox Party Box games. Because if we did, all we need is just the code for that, and all of us could just kind of fuck around.
Any of you guys play Game Developer Tycoon?
No.
I do not have it.
Oh, it's so good.
Oh, isn't that the one you were streaming?
Yeah, probably. I love it.
It sure is a thing.
Yeah, I'm a simulator guy. I mean, fucking city builders love it.
Yeah.
I mean, I grew up on, like, real-time strategies and stuff, like Command & Conquer and Warcraft.
I grew up on shit like Monopoly. I am beast at Monopoly.
Like the which Command & Conquer did you play, Cody? The real old ones?
Red Alert 2.
I grew up on Red Alert 2.
I mean, I quit playing after, like, Tiberian Sun, but
I didn't play any of the newer ones, really.
Yeah, there's there's an open source Red Alert 2 game out there. It's pretty fun.
Yeah, they released it for free on Origin for like a month, but that was a while back.
I downloaded it. I have it.
Yeah, I gave my dad that. That was like the only game he would play. He's like in his 60s, and I gave it to him for like his birthday about like less than a year ago, and he's got over 600 hours on it.
Jeez.
I mean, like,
because he's just retired. So.
It's amazing. Like, I remember just like I had it for the PlayStation as well. My cousin and I would link our PlayStations and play it. You remember doing that? I don't know if you remember doing that.
I only played it on a computer.
I don't know. I mean, I played it on the computer too, but we had it for the PlayStation. And we also had StarCraft for the 64, which was awful. It was so bad.
Yeah, it doesn't sound like it would be that good.
It was like worse than The Sims on the PlayStation. It was the worst thing in the world. Yeah, I mean, there's no real good RTSs anymore. I mean, I haven't played a good... I mean, there's like Empire at War with Star Wars, but...
Yeah, that was a good one.
But I mean,
there's
that's...
There's no major ones anymore.
I know they did, like, the Total War, Rome 2, whatever, and...
Yeah.
They're coming out with that Warhammer, or came out with it already, I think.
Yeah.
I watched a little bit of that.
Yeah,
I watched a little bit of that, and it seemed pretty good.
I never played the Total War series. I mean... I'd take it to mythology. What else? Ugh. And... I wish I could get into Kerbal Space Program, but I just...
I dick around in it a little bit. Like, I kind of know... I know the principle behind how to do stuff. I just can't really do it. So I end up just making the most ridiculously huge rockets and seeing how far they can go just straight up.
Yeah. And then I also have Fishing Planet.
Oh, shit.
Just go night fishing, get little nibbles.
Anyone have Skullgirls?
No.
No, but literally like a week ago, my boyfriend asked if I wanted that.
Oh, God.
I don't like those type of games.
You do?
I synced my Steam account with a friend of mine who has, like, all he plays is, like, indie games and kind of, like, Japanese games.
Oh,
so
like,
I was like, maybe he has Skullgirls.
Like those anime novel games.
Visual novels are quality, man. Yeah.
Visual novels aren't that bad. Depending on the visual novel, there are some pretty fucking dumb ones out there.
Well, yeah.
Why don't we all just play Unreal Tournament? Let's just do that.
I don't have that.
It's free. Go ahead and download it. I'll be here.
Yeah, I'll be here for a couple hours if we wanted, or a couple years if we wanted to do that.
Yeah, no, like the updates are like 4 gigs. I'm like, oh, that's why I don't play it, because it has to update. I'm like, oh. But I mean, it's pretty amazing. It's just like Unreal Tournament, like the original one.
How about Nidhogg?
What?
Nidhogg.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I want that game so bad.
I have it, and I don't know why.
I love that game. So much fun.
I have a game called Mountain, where you are a mountain. That's the premise of the game.
I think I have that. I have that on a an alt Steam account.
Why the fuck do you have an alt Steam account?
It was because I was banned in CS:GO. So I had to skip around it.
So you bought CS:GO a second time?
I was banned on something. No, it wasn't CS:GO because I've never bought in CS:GO. What did I use it for? Oh, I used it to play Dota with a friend because I was too high a level, so we were getting into ridiculous matchmaking.
Oh. Jeez.
But, I was like, you had to buy a game. You have to buy a game to validate your friends list to, like, be able to accept friend requests. You can't just do it with free-to-play games. So I bought the cheapest game on Steam, which at the time was Mountain.
Nice.
I don't think I've ever played it.
I will probably never play it. Fuck it, let's boot it up right now. Never mind, I have to install it.
We should all, like, play Saints Row the Third or something.
Hell yeah.
That would be amazing.
Cody, do you have Saints Row 4?
Do I have Saints Row 4?
Yeah.
No.
You should totally get it when you have a chance. It's really good.
I just accidentally loaded Scribble Knots.
Nice.
Which is fun. I do enjoy it. So
Scribble Knots is really weird.
Yeah, I have Scribble Knots Unlimited.
Yeah, so do I. It's fun. Oh, it's loud. Well, I mean, sure.
Should all totally get Secrets of Grindia?
What?
Grindia, you mean?
I call it Grindia. Because Grindia sounds stupid.
Skipping the joke. I assumed that was the joke. Like, the entire game is, like, grinding but fun.
Mount your
Actually,
friends.
Actually, yeah, kinda.
Mount your friends.
I have not played that, and I don't know if I want to.
It looks... It's really dumb and really funny.
Yeah, I've seen it on YouTube.
I have two friends that play it and get way too competitive over it. They have a mounting rivalry.
What about...
Josh!
We should all get a big Josh. Civilizations game going.
I don't own Civ.
Josh!
We don't have that kind of time.
To Tim earlier. That's true. It could replace D&D. We could easily spend that much time in a Civ 5 game.
Yeah. Getting fucking to the Stone Age. I haven't played a full Civ game in like 10 years.
Yeah, I haven't played a full Civ game in like a year or two.
I don't have a whole lot of multiplayer games.
Sorry, Sky the Madden, I did not know you were here. We're waiting on our DM. Because he's apparently dead. But just you stick around, because we'll get started fucking probably next year.
He power napped so hard. He's
honestly,
we
might
now.
Just end up be playing something else because fuck our DM. I have Castle Crashers and Battle Block Theater.
Oh, I have Castle Crashers. I'd have to install it. Dang.
I have none of those.
Wait, how big is it? Oh, I could download Castle Crashers.
Cody, do you have Castle Crashers?
It anyway, it's
I don't game. Know what it is. Is it free?
No.
No. It's probably dirt cheap. It was big, like, in,
it's
15, shit, probably, like, 2007, 2008.
What is it?
It's
like, a four-player side-scroller beat-em-up.
Yeah.
Basically.
With a medieval theme to it.
There's magic.
Oh, God, I would... Like, The Gathering?
No. I was talking about it in the game.
I mean, I can go get my decks. Let's do it.
Dude, shit, I wish, man. I could find my magic deck.
Fucking got it right here. I don't know what game.
I was so playing magic while you were in diapers.
And how old are you, bitch?
I'm almost 30.
Okay, then yeah.
Oh, yeah, God, Cody.
You could argue that one.
I just kind of realized that. Oh my god.
Yeah.
You're old enough to be almost someone's father.
I mean, you.
I think we're tied.
How old are you?
19.
19. When do you turn 20?
Mid-March.
Oh, okay, so I'm older than you.
Oh, Alex is the baby.
The wee babby.
He's a little Bobby. A little Bobby.
We should do War Thunder. War Thunder is great.
Oh, I don't have War Thunder.
It's free.
I installed it.
My computer takes 6 years to install shit, so.
I loved it. Chivalry 2. Loved it.
Literally the only MMO games I have are Battle Block Theater, Dungeon Defenders, Terra, which I don't play anymore, so I don't know why that's on here, Town of Salem, Castle Crashers. I think that's
it. It'll take me an hour and a half to download Castle Crashers.
Jesus.
Dude, it took me, like, 10 minutes.
Yeah, dude, if you think Alaska Net was slow before, imagine what happens when they cap your bandwidth and you go over.
Fuck.
Oh, shit.
30 kilobytes a second.
So, I have this weird, like, text-based. Oh, yeah. Text-based, like movie simulator. You make movies. And I have 31 hours in it. I'm gonna load it and see some of my like movie titles. I don't remember really playing this. So let's. Oh shit! It's like super loud. Why is it loud? It's just a simulator game.
It's just a simulator.
Oh no! Stop trying to install things. What are you doing?
Gonna try to pull up the lasers and feelings rules.
Yeah, let's do it. Okay. Load game. Okay. Let's see my filmography. Apparently I have a two-part series called William in Trouble.
That's a classic movie. I enjoyed that one.
William in Trouble 2, I heard, was better than the first, if you can believe it.
Oh wow.
Apparently I made a remake of Gulliver's Travels. What was it? What?
Beautiful.
A movie called Kingdom of Hell.
These are some nice titles, not a lot.
So I have a movie called Evolution. It's called They Thought They Finished College 30 Years Ago. Now a group of 55-year-olds have to go back and learn new ways to save their company.
What the fuck?
That sounds like you're dealing with some, you're letting out some personal issues in that one.
There's another one called My Name is God. His name is God. He kind of created everything, but he has a problem. Can two idiots off the street help our creator?
that'd be a pretty solid comedy.
Yeah.
Alright. Might just send this lasers and feelings thing to everyone. It's a game. It's, you know.
It's something.
Someone made it.
Shit happens.
So the synopsis for William in Trouble is a thief steals a multi-million dollar sports car, only discover the vehicle is a living entity.
Is his name William?
Yeah. I don't know. Oh, like I wrote these. I wrote that description. What was I doing?
How old were you?
I don't know, this was a couple of years ago.
So it's basically like Herbie or something, if Herbie got stolen.
Herbie Fully Loaded?
No, the original one. It's the old ones. Those are great. I watched those as a kid. Apparently I have over $1 billion in revenue, so yeah, cool. Well, that was exciting.
Indeed.
Ah, Wheeling in Trouble. Ooh, Democracy 3. I haven't played this in a while.
I don't know why, but for some reason I thought of the TV show Charles in Charge.
How is Democracy 3?
As exciting as you can imagine it would be. But good. I've played 2 years, but... Good. I mean, it's a political text.
So hire someone else.
So, what can you... What can you...
This guy.
Lasers and feelings.
So apparently I just saw that that is a song.
What?
Lasers and Feelings.
Oh.
That this game is based on a song. Which completely shattered my predisposition. I mean, if we want to do this until Josh gets here, random bullshit can happen.
Who's DMing?
Is he gonna get here, though?
Can I DM?
If you want to.
Yeah. I'll do it.
Because only you and I know how to play it.
So, is it lasers that you have to roll below your threshold, or is it feelings?
I just sent a link in the Skype chat.
Yeah, I'm reading this. So, you want to roll under your number. Okay. So, between 1 and... What is it?
Honestly, okay, so I'm not going to read it. I'm just going to have you guys explain it to me later.
We don't even know how it works.
Look, I'll explain it to you. So basically, at least read the first 4 numbers, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. That'll explain how you create your get thing.
Ooh. Ew.
Mm. All right. Don't you say that to me.
Not elaborating on what just happened at all.
Did you shit yourself?
No. Okay, so fuck it. I'm going to elaborate on it because it's only us here and, like, nobody's in the stream. And Alex is gone, so his opinion of me won't be destroyed. So, for the past, like, year, there's been this growth on my neck. And I know that sounds disgusting, but it's like a pimple, kind of. But it's just, like, on the back of my neck.
Could be a cyst.
Maybe. Maybe, actually. I'm gonna keep that in mind. So, like, every now and again, I squeeze it to see if it'll pop. And so I was just squeezing it, and just, I felt something come out. Like, it's like if you were squeezing a ketchup packet. And I just felt something come out, and there was this, like, white foamish thing on my finger.
Ooh, that's pretty gnarly, dude. I never use that word, ever. I don't know why I just said that.
Because you were alive almost in the 70s.
I mean, not really. I mean, sort of.
If it's been there for a while, it's probably a cyst.
I had a huge fucking boil on my ass once.
Ooh.
How the fuck do you get a boil on your ass?
Who knows? It just happens.
Holding hot water to it.
So, do we have a roll 20 chat?
God damn it, Terry. God damn.
Because I want to roll for the story.
Oh, okay. Let me roll20.net. I guess you should set up a room so you'll be DM.
Okay. It's my DM.
God voice. Damn it.
I've been smoking for 40 years.
I've been smoking for 19 years.
Let's see.
So I can't do a really fucked up voice this time because my throat won't allow it.
Charles in charge of our days and our lives.
So I'm probably just going to use my normal voice. And it's going to be glorious.
So I can't use the same room we used before.
If any of us could figure out how the fuck to get back in there. I mean, it's probably in the Skype chat at some point, right?
I need probably. To sneeze.
I'll just create a new game.
Okay, good. Wonderful. Fantastic. Good job, Cody.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we need to create our characters, which is like a 10-second endeavor.
All right, I'm back.
I get muffins.
All right, Alex, are you ready for some lasers and feelings?
I'm already full of feelings.
All right.
How do I link the chat?
How do you do what?
How do I link the chat?
You copy and paste the link.
But it's not there.
Well, you. Okay.
Okay, hold on. I'm gonna mock do it. If that makes any sense.
Uh huh.
Just like to tell you how to do it. Sign in. There we go. Create a new game. Mock thingy. Stuff is the tag. I'm ready. Create the game.
Oh, this is interesting.
Okay. Player link for this campaign. So, you see where it says the player link for this campaign is blank?
Oh, when you create it?
Yeah, after you create it.
Okay, where did I see that? Oh, yeah, I see that.
Yeah, just click on that. Or copy and paste it, or do whatever. Yeah, if you just click on it, it'll... No, never mind. Don't just click on it, copy and paste it. There we go. We got this. And now I can draw on this board. Hee-hee-hee-hee-hee!
Whee! Oh.
Apparently Josh is dead.
Does that work?
Probably is.
And join game. It's gonna feel so weird without that growth back there. That's exactly why I said that. Alright, we need to draw our spaceship first of all.
I don't know what's going on.
Dibs.
All right.
So honestly, I think I'm just gonna kind of chill here and watch, because I'm confused.
Alex is gonna be confused too, so you can both be confused. Look, Cody and I are the veterans.
Default pink.
I'm trying to make the best cafe ever.
All right, here, I'm gonna make our ship.
Okay, so I'm going to roll for the story, guys. It's gonna be fucking great.
Do it in a private way, so we don't know what it is.
Oh, how do I do that?
There should be a way that you can hide your roles as a DM.
I already see a penis.
That's the ship.
It's a penis.
Yes, that's ding-a-ling.
It's a penis.
See, it's got the cockpit.
God damn it. Alex is so proud of himself.
I'm more proud of the fact that I improv'd that. I wasn't planning that one going in.
You need to change the title to Lasers and Feelings.
Oh, yeah.
Lasers and Penises.
Lasers and Penises, there you go.
I don't see where to hide.
Alright, let's build an actual ship now.
Lasers and cockpits.
Okay, so let's see their little default picture. Okay, that's just a Star Trek ripoff.
Okay, so basically the way this goes down is there are no set rules in this game. You can try to do anything that you want as long as you roll for it. So whenever you go to roll for something, you either roll lasers, which is cognitive thinking or scientific-y things. Or you roll feelings, which is feelings-based things. So if you're doing something in the name of love, that's
reason and passion.
Exactly. So you roll for it. What was it with lasers you wanted to get under your number? Cody?
Yes.
Huh? Yes, laser.
I'm reading the PDF. Yeah. Okay. Under.
Lasers you want to get under your number. Feelings you want to get over. And if you get exactly your number, which I'll explain later, you get a laser feelings where you get to ask basically any question that you want, meta or no. Like, if you know what that means, I'm not going to elaborate. Shut up, Serivich. So,
hold on real quick, guys.
Okay. To start off making your characters, if we go to the PDF.
I don't want to make a new PDF. I'm lazy.
I sent a link in the chat. You just have to click on that link and it'll open in a new tab and it's ready to go.
I don't want to do it.
Is that just the... Oh, that's the one I already
what
have
chat?
Open.
What chat? I don't have shit.
In Skype chat.
I know.
Group chat? You should have it.
I don't have it.
It's right above where Cody put the Roll 20 link. Right below where I said, get back in here.
Right above it?
Mm-hmm. Mm. Oh my god, I've been sneezing all day. Nice D.
Thank you.
It's probably the first time he's ever heard that in his life.
Hey.
Possibly. And he's not the one that said it, too.
Given how tall he is, never mind.
That sounds like something I'd say then, depending on how tall he is.
Can't go any further without making things just very inconvenient.
Inconvenient?
Inconvenient.
It's not the right words, bro.
Okay, so we need to choose a style for our character. So... Yeah. So, last time we were able to, like, come up with any sort of style for our characters... And the character I made was Fellatio Philandra.
And... Oh, fuck.
You can guess how that went.
A lot of passion rolls.
Well, let's just say that at one point, I had my face buried in the zombie's crotch trying to find its dick. So that was a fantastic time. Unfortunately, the zombie did not have any parts at all. So,
which unfortunately cripples the way you do combat.
Yep. So, what was his name? Dusty Dicer. That was Cody's name. He was this ace pilot.
Lasers and cockpits.
Yep. And at one point, he ended up locating me with his compass penis. So that was great.
That's sexy.
So this is going to be a fantastic time. So we pretty much abandoned the plot right from the get-go. He went to a space Costco.
Space Costco.
We tried to go Space West a lot. It didn't work. Fuck, I need to upload that, because that was actually really good. He went to Space Costco and got 5 gallons of baked beans.
It's a good investment.
It is. He had this cart too. He had this like rocket ship cart as he was getting his groceries that just pulled slightly to the left. He ended up rolling really shittily on a roll while he was trying to get away from the Space Costco because he ended up stealing the baked beans. And... like, he got such a shitty roll that his spaceship ended up pulling slightly to the left. Just forever.
Okay, so... Sorry. Okay, so I'm rolling for the story...
We need to make Fellatio Philandra's twin brother.
What's his twin brother's name?
Got a really good idea for a character.
Oh boy. Furry Fred, let's go.
Furry Fred?
I don't know why.
You're still tabbed in the starting soon make yourselves comfortable page.
Yep. I haven't set up the other scene yet, so I'm putting that off as long as possible.
Oh god, that's weird.
It's either gonna be Furry Fred or Furry Fernando. But I can't do a Spanish accent. Alright, I need a new notepad document. roll with Furry Fred B. Oh, I also tried to eat just this random animal. I took a bite out of its shin. That was fun.
Because reasons?
I was hungry.
And because reasons.
And I wanted to fillet it, but I kind of missed.
Yeah, so because reasons. Yeah.
Oh, this is it. This is.
Are you looking something up on the internet?
Oh. I'm getting my character down, alright?
Alright.
Oh, good. That's always going to be good. Okay, so lasers. Okay. Alright, so I'm ready whenever you pieces of shit are.
Oh, shit.
I want to see how this plays out.
Alright. Yeah.
Can Furry Fred be a farmer?
No, I'm not. I don't have any of my character shit.
It's really easy to make a character.
I wanna watch.
Look, I will make one for you.
No, I wanna watch.
Then that's no fine. You watch. Do whatever.
I'll help come up with stupid shit then.
Trust me, I already got some shit down.
So whenever you two fellas are done, we'll get this going.
Is there a reason why it auto...
Why did the ship disappear?
I deleted it because I'm trying to... Oh, okay, there we go. All
right, so...
I'm going to make a new ship once I get my...
DM.
Thing.
Uh-huh.
Can Furry Fred be a farmer?
I don't see why not.
Yeah, Furry Fred can be whatever you want. I mean...
Just keep him away from the animals.
Oh, boy. Nobody's keeping Furry Fred away from his... Wow, this is a lot of alliteration. Can't handle it.
I hate alliteration.
Farmer Furry Fred.
Farmer Furry Fred fucks.
Foxes.
Fox
Furry Fred Fox friends.
See, you added an extra word that just makes it, I don't know, not as catchy.
Deeper.
Farmer Furry Fred fucks furry foxes.
There you go.
I was going to say furry friends.
Oh. Maybe.
I need to figure out a role.
Okay. Choose your number from 2 to 5. Alright.
So I'm going to try to keep track of these guys. So just tell me what your number is. Furry Fred, the farmer.
I'm just figuring out a role. Cause I don't really...
My number is 2.
I can make any role that I want, though, really. Is 2? Right?
What?
Like,
it can
my
be
role?
Any...
Okay.
You can roll me whatever the fuck you want it to be. I think I was... I was a pilot, but...
Yeah, and I was a scientist. We just went with the shit that was there, basically.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hey.
Yeah.
What was your number?
2.
What's your number, 2. Alex?
I'll go 4.
Okay, what's your character's name?
I haven't figured out a name yet.
Oh,
all I know, I have a general idea.
4. We'll wing it. That's fine. Okay. So...
Right, the style is Android.
My character doesn't know your name, so I'm just going to make up names for you every time I talk to you.
Yes.
Alex the Android. That's what I'm putting it
when you make
down
up
on my
names.
Notepad.
What's his actual name? That was when you make him up, you can be, like, somewhat close, but not really.
Oh, no, I'm going to call him, like, Scott.
What was your
Scott.
Was your name? Farmer Fred?
Furry Fred.
Furry Fred.
He's Farmer Furry Fred.
Well, my style is furry. My name is Fred. I don't know what the fuck's up with me and F names recently. Philandra, Fred...
Okay, so plus 1 if you're prepared. Try to write all this stuff down so I don't have to keep going to the actual fucking PDF.
Oh, right.
Plus
we also...
if you're an expert. Which I will determine, of course. So,
all right, Alex. We gotta make a ship.
Yeah, okay, well...
All right.
Should I read out the generic story?
Oh, go for it.
Okay. Sure. So, you are the crew of the interstellar scout ship Raptor. Your mission is to explore uncharted regions of space, deal with aliens both friendly and deadly, and defend the consortium worlds against dangers. Space dangers, of course. Captain Darcy has been overcome by the strange psychic entity known as Something Else, leaving you to fend for yourselves while he recovers in a medical pod. Okay, so we have the ship, right?
I hate to be the stereotypical girl, but when I heard Darcy, I thought of Pride and Prejudice and that douchebag.
Don't know what it's about. Anyway, so as a thing, you guys need to pick two strengths for the Raptor. Fast, nimble, well-armed, powerful shield, superior sensors, cloaking device, and fighter craft.
Curious as to what Alex's picks are.
What are they?
Oh. USS Raptor.
So what strengths do you guys want your ship?
You pick one, I'll pick the other.
I already had an idea for it.
Okay, well, what's yours?
Well, since it's a raptor, speed and weapons.
So you want nimble, okay. Okay. No, I mean that. No, speed. You want speed. So you want fast. That's what you want. So you cool with that? Fast and well-armed?
Yep, I'm cool with that.
Well-armed. Now...
Ooh, it's a raptor. Fred likes this.
So now you guys need to pick a problem. You need to be either a fuel hog... only one medical pod, and of course Captain Darcy's already in it, horrible circuit breakers, or grim reputation, which basically means Captain Darcy has done some shit in the past.
Like people will turn us away and shit.
Yeah, that's what we picked.
Yeah, Space Costco was really interesting.
Oh yeah. Space Costco. All those baked beans.
Alright, I'm thinking horrible circuit breakers.
Okay, horrible. Okay. Circuit breakers. Okay, now, what's yours, Alex?
Pick for problem?
Yeah.
We just picked one.
We only need one. I'm stupid.
Are you okay with horrible circuit breakers?
Yeah, sure.
Alright.
This is going to be fun. And I believe... I think we're good. Okay, so let me.
Right, I need a notepad. I need to start writing some shit down.
Okay, so basically the way it works is you can roll two different ways. You can roll a standard roll, which is of course the 1d6. That's hey, I'm gonna give this a try. However, if you convince me you're prepared or an expert on whatever subject this is, I will give you an extra dice. So you get 2d6. So, if none of your dice succeed, basically shit's gonna go bad. If one die succeeds, you're gonna barely manage it.
I guess my profile picture didn't save.
Actually, you can get 3d6. I didn't know that.
When you do a standard roll, if you're prepared and if you're an expert.
And an expert, yeah, okay, so yeah. Basically, and so you're gonna have a fucking hell of a time with lasers.
I'm a farmer, though. Like, I work around space equipment for farming. Like, I use a laser shovel, a laser hoe.
You gotta make sure.
A laser hoe.
My picture is now fixed, so.
So yeah, if you have to roll a one to get a successful laser.
Wait, what if you match it? Oh, never mind. That's a laser feeling.
Yeah, you get a laser quill. You can ask me any question you want. All right, you guys ready?
Hang on, I'm writing all my
shots.
All right, I need to close some serious tabs.
Let's see, plus. Okay.
I am best cafe manager.
Okay, time to crack open this water.
Mm-hmm. Water.
I'm trying to be more from the north.
I am most north.
The water's killing me.
Alright, I think I got everything for my character.
Okay. What about you, Tim? You good?
Yeah, like, I'm assuming Alex over there wrote...
An hour and a half, I'm gonna head to bed because I have to be up and work all day tomorrow.
That's fine, this game doesn't take that long anyway.
I'm assuming Alex just, like, wrote this whole fucking novel over there. I have two lines. The first one is Furry Fred Farmer, and the second one is number two.
Perfect.
Android HK-44, general purpose droid, 4... character goal, banging every species of feminine aliens around.
I forgot my goal. I'm going to come up with
Oh my god. Your Morneros is showing.
I'm going to try to crossbreed broccoli and bratwurst into a plant.
Oh, okay. Well, maybe you'll find your, real thing. Alright, so you guys tell me when you're ready and I will set the scene.
Oh shit.
Don't worry, my goal last time was I wanted to redefine what it meant to be a woman.
Mine was I wanted to find the spiciest dish in the universe.
The spice. That sounds like a sweet, like, RV-based road trip comedy.
It was like a space trip. It went bad.
Oh, crap.
Space Jam?
Never mind.
Alright. I'm ready to
do Raptor.
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 Those things coming off the cylinders are supposed to be claws, but I couldn't really draw them.
Oh, they look good. It's like a utility knife.
This is
like
what our ship actually looks like too.
A Swiss Army knife saw.
Alright, I think we're ready.
Okay. You ready, Alex?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay. So, I'm going to set the scene for you guys. Okay. So basically, the entire crew of the SSS Raptor has left on holiday. However, the only three remaining to, you know, skeleton crew is the captain, which he never takes a break, and the two wonderful help, Furry Fred and Alex the Android. They're just kind of, you guys are just kind of taking care of the ship while the rest of the crew is on a holiday. And when you guys are just traveling across the universe, Captain Darcy slips, falls, knocks himself into a coma. And what do you know? He also slips and falls and hits on the light speed. Like that big button, you know? So as you guys are trying to scramble and get him into, you know, the medical pod, which you do, you guys, you know, go running back to the bridge, slam your fist on the stopping light speed button, because, you know, you guys are simpletons, you need that button. And
just a big flashing button, stop light speed.
And so you stop, and all of a sudden you find yourself in an uncharted galaxy, being hailed by the fearsome, but unknown to you, Zorgon the Conqueror. How do you guys respond?
Well, we're fucked.
What kind of name is Zorgon?
Zorgon the Conqueror.
I feel like that this is going to be one of them situations where we just stay here and we get fucked over by some evil alien overlord.
Oh my god, he went all Southern Farmer.
What? Of course I went Southern Farmer.
The Southern Galaxy.
So yeah, we're space south.
Oh god.
So do you guys want to accept his, you know, you know, his hailing, or do you want to, or what? How do you want to react to it?
I would like to use a little transceiver. Is that what it's called? I won't try to talk to him and ask him how's he doing. Would he like some broccoli?
Well, why don't you roll me a laser and see what happens?
Oh, this is going to be lovely.
It certainly is.
Oh, God.
Well, fuck.
Yeah. Okay, so you failed. So what happens is on your way to hitting the transceiver is you slip, fall, hit your head, and shit yourself.
And shoot yourself.
But
owie.
Yeah, so and basically nothing happens. So you just shit yourself, and this guy's still trying to wait, and he's very impatient.
Well, I guess CP3O, I guess you should like try to talk to him, because I'm a little predisposed at the moment.
I'm surprised he knew such a big word.
I know words. I'm stupid. I'm not stupid. I'm a farmer.
I'm stupid. I'm not a farmer.
So what are you going to do, Alex?
All right. Well, my plan was to use this online tone generator as my character voice. But it's not working out. Oh. So.
Rip, my heart's broken.
All right. I'm going to attempt the same thing Fred did.
Okay, roll me a laser.
It's awfully stanky down here.
It's a D6, right?
Yeah, 1D6. Okay. So you do it. So you hit the button, and on your guys' view screen, this hideous insect monster comes.
Oh my God, he's gorgeous.
Comes flashing on the screen, and he has his arms crossed, and he's saying to you two, "Why are you guys in my sector? Who are you?"
Well, our old Captain Darcy, he got a little bit of a headache on account of he bashed his head into the warp speed button, so we ended up having to throw him into the medical pod. But when we came back out and we pressed the stop light speed button, we ended up being here, and neither of us know how to really pilot this. So if you could like give us a manual or something, or maybe just tow us to the nearest truck stop or whatever, that would be wonderful. Thank you, Your Excellency. By the way, you are looking magnificent. Is that suede?
He just stares at you, mandibles clicking and clacking.
Oh yeah, I keep talking dirty.
And so he's like, "So what you're telling me is you have no idea where you are.
That's
and
right.
You have no idea how to pilot this ship."
Captain Darcy is kind of our only pilot. We were training a new one, but he kind of got lost back in, where were we? Like, I think it was called Alcatraz. And it was this planet all on its own. And, well, we were there, and he was getting taken off the ship by these evil, evil cartel members. And so we tried to save him, but they ended up cutting off his head. So we tried to train the head to pilot, but it didn't work out. So we had to kick him off the team. He got a nice severance package. It's okay. You don't have to worry about that. But, you know, we're just a little, you know, out of it right now. Plus, the rest of our crew's out on, I think it's like Hanukkah or something. So, you know, we're a little SOL, I guess you would say. By the way, your eyes are beautiful, and I would like to try and seduce him.
Oh, okay. So, roll me a feeling.
And I am a furry.
Oh, well, then I believe you're an expert. So you get 2d6.
What was the other thing? Just to see if I can argue it. I think I'm prepared because I've been sweet talking to him this whole time. Oh my god, I'm not going to be able to talk without a southern drawl for the next fucking week.
Oh yeah, alright. You can have a 3d6. That's fine. Yeah. All fail. Let's see it.
I'm waiting for it. All nat ones.
That would be good for him. No, that'd be bad.
That'd be bad, because it's not.
I did get a lasers feeling.
Look at that. You did get a lasers. Your number's a 2.
For feelings, it's a 4.
Oh, for feelings, it's a 4. That's right.
A 2. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you don't pick a number. It's just one number, I believe, isn't it?
Yeah, let me... What did I write down? Yeah, my number is a 2. Lasers, you wanted to get under. Feelings, you wanted to get over.
So you, I mean, he's swooning. I mean, you can visibly see him, you know, almost visibly see his heart thumping. He's like, puts his hands on the chair in the bridge of his ship. He sighs, and he's like, could we have a private moment?
Oh, yeah. My bedroom's a little not great at the moment. We're in the process of getting a new maid, too. Why don't you show me to yours, Your Excellency?
And he's like, would you come aboard?
Oh, please. I will. I sure will come.
Can I tag along?
And then... I would like to try to seduce him into a 3-way.
Okay, so
dude, that's not my character goal.
You're getting 1d6.
It's your character goal now.
Okay.
Roll me 1d6.
Me?
Yeah, and also,
Oh well, I rolled a 6.
Oh, I thought you wanted me to roll it.
Well, both of you.
I got a 6.
What's your number? So this is, you want to get over your number, so, wow.
Tim, have you noticed the times that we've both rolled, we've tied? 3-3-6-6.
So this is, okay. So.
We're not, having a 3-way with a giant insect monster.
Not only have you convinced this like, brutish, unmerciful, murderous insect conqueror to fall in head over heels in love with you, but he also looks over at Alex Android and he's like, I've always loved synthetic flesh.
Oh, so have I. You wouldn't believe what he can do.
I am a little uncomfortable.
You are no such thing. We are going to have a rip-roaring good time with Mr. What's your name again?
My name is Zorgon.
Zorgon.
But you can call me Big Daddy Z.
Big Daddy Z. Hey, my daddy wanted us to call him Big Daddy Z. What a coincidence. Let's get on with this.
And then...
Are they secretly related or something?
Oh, God, he's going to be my father.
I have no idea what's happening.
Once Fred turns of age, he'll get one of those mandible claws.
Daddy. So, but at this moment, his second in command is watching this whole unfold.
Interfere and I will fucking cut you in half.
In like frustration, he's like, "Sir, these are unwanted people in our sector. They could ruin our plans. We have a schedule."
Well, I hope we fit in that schedule. And I wink at him, trying to seduce him too. All right. I'm trying to seduce their entire crew.
Should roll one more seduction.
Can I argue because I'm a furry?
If you want, you can have 2d6. Alright, you can have it.
He was not prepared for this.
Okay. Well, I have a contingency plan. And so Zorgon, right, he's anticipating his He's in the heat of the moment, and he's like, "I want the both of you to come on my ship right now."
Oh yeah, we sure will.
I want you to, and we'll spend hours making love. But at that moment, the alert on both of your ships start going off.
Whale hail!
And another ship jumps out of light speed and starts firing on Zorgon.
No, sweetie pie!
And then the connection breaks between you two. But also,
I loved him.
Yeah. But he sends you one last message, and he's just like, and he gives you coordinates to a planet.
I hope it's so full of them creatures.
Yeah. So what are you guys gonna do with these coordinates?
Well, I would like to take out our manual of flight and quickly read it. Actually, I'm gonna show it to the android because I think he knows how to read through these things very quick like, and fucking,
you are correct. I can read, whereas you might not be able to.
Okay. I don't even know what read means. Shut up. You are an IDOT.
So and also at this moment, you're also being hailed by the other ship and asking your affiliation. You know, they're basically saying, who are you? What are you doing?
We were sex slaves.
Is this our official backstory?
So are you guys going
to... He's just got a hard on all the time.
The whole time.
Wait, let me see your face.
No, it's just an audio message.
What are you wearing right now, Dan?
A jumpsuit?
Oh, what's underneath that jumpsuit?
Fur.
Oh my god. All right.
Damn it.
All right. Apple over there, you need to like not be here anymore. I'm going to have a nice time with this gentleman and or lady over here.
So
can't even tell by the voice.
So basically, you guys need to make a choice. Either make yourself known to these newcomers, right? Or follow the coordinates to the planet that Zorgon has provided you. Because either way, you know, you're kind of in the middle of crossfire right now.
I'm going to look at my space watch. Be like, well, hell, I got an appointment. I'm going to have to take you up on that offer later, sweetie pie. All right. And I'm going to casually meander over to the light speed button.
Oh, God.
Not the light speed button.
Okay. All right, so... well,
it was nice knowing you. My name is Jim Bob. So if you ever need to get in touch with me, I'll leave my card right here in space for you. Just be sure to come out and pick it up later. So... yeah, I will talk to you later. And right as I'm saying I'm going to slam the light speed button.
Okay, well, roll me a laser. Yeah, you don't get anything else. Just roll.
Son of a bitch.
Okay, so basically what has happened is that when you hit light speed, for one, you didn't enter the coordinates of the planet, so you don't know where you're going.
I'm not good at this.
And two, as you guys are making your jump to light speed, you slam into Zorgon's ship.
Oh no, sweetie.
Oh, shit.
And cause one of your, engines to basically, you know, not explode, but just really go to hell. So you're only one engine. You guys are fucking spinning in space. Going light speed.
Way!
Like
half light.
Yeah. And nice so... but at this moment, those goddamn circuit breakers kick in. And they start... so your lights start flickering. Light speed dies. You guys have barely gone anywhere. And you start crashing towards the planet below you.
I just start screaming in data. So it's just pure binary.
One zero zero one zero zero. I'm just trying to keep up with him.
1 0 1 0 bud 1 1 1. Just running around, trying to fix circuit breakers.
Oh well, okay. Well, roll me a laser.
I'll try to fix the circuit.
You're an X. I would. What's your?
I have 4.
Well, I mean, what's your role?
What would I write? General purpose droid. So I'd probably know how to fix circuit breakers.
Okay, so give me, you can have 2d6.
I'm trying to go and find my potatoes so they don't get hurt.
Okay, so you fail.
Wasn't it lasers you had to roll under?
I got one of them.
Okay, so you get one of them. So basically, you kind of fix it. I mean, you kind of cobbled it together just enough to slow you down before you careen into this, planet and die. So you got that going for you.
You also got a laser feeling?
You get with that one question. Don't ask away. Or you can save it for later. It's your choice.
Okay, so the alien race that Zorgon is.
Mm-hmm.
Is there a feminine gender in their species?
Yes, they are a, multi-gender race. They have females, they have males.
Oh, sweet Jesus. I have a case of the vapors.
However, they're very hard to tell apart, and you don't know whether Zorgon...
What sexuality is your guy?
Are you?
Both.
Okay.
Twice the fun.
So, bye.
I don't like to identify as one thing. Thank you very much. I'm very progressive.
there's a male and female.
All right.
Good, perfect. Good question.
That's my character goals.
All right.
Should have asked if they have broccoli.
So basically you guys, you were able to slow the ship down just enough. But you still make a crash landing on the planet, right? And this is, the land on this planet is very sparse, right? And you crash kind of halfway in the water and halfway in land. So, but you guys are kind of on the outskirts of a very large island. What are you going to do?
I'm going to take our chain out of the vehicle. And I'm going to tie it around one of the wings, and I'm going to try to drag the thing up toward an island where it'll not be submerged.
You're kind of halfway submerged, just the front end's kind of pooping in the water a little bit.
Yeah, I want to drag it all the way up to land.
roll me a laser.
Wouldn't that be a feelings though?
What is? I mean, you're not trying to build rapport, do passion, I would say. Science or reason, I mean.
Well, I'm not very scientific.
I guess it's a feeling. Probably a feeling.
Fuck it.
Science is a feeling.
She blinded me with science.
So.
We were listening to that earlier.
So, you grab the biggest chain you can find out of the supply closet. I mean, this thing's massive. But I mean, the days you've spent on your farm, your muscles are bulging. I mean, the veins are popping.
Tell me more.
You're like Brock Lesnar.
Oh.
She blinded me with science.
And so you wrap the chain around the back of the ship, right? When you go outside, so the oxygen level's fine. It's a beautiful planet.
Oh yeah, I guess we didn't check that.
No, but I gave that one to you for now. So you just fucking you beast it. You just pull the ship right out of the water. Hell, you even kind of like.
Am I still in the ship?
Yeah, you're still in the ship, and you kind of lift it up in the air. You get a little crazy, and you're spinning the ship with your head.
And then you just can't compute.
My power level's rising.
Yeah, and then you set it down on the sand after, showboating a little bit.
And I'm going to flex really hard at the android.
And at this moment, the native tribe of, you know, women. It's an all women society. Come out from the trees and look and start looking at you guys. They have spears in their hands. They're conversing amongst themselves.
We come in peace. Do you speak the common language of English?
And roll me a feeling.
Guess I can't say.
It slowly turns into D&D.
Okay.
So, as it turns out, there is one among them that speaks very, very, very broken common. So she, this statuesque woman, she's like 6'1".
Ooh, yeah. You remind me of my mother.
Okay, cool. She's holding a spear. She looks at you, and she says, "You come with us."
We were going to do that with an alien overlord earlier.
Yes, ma'am.
And she starts, like, jabbing spears at you guys. The whole tribe surrounds you and starts poking. So where are you at this point, Alex?
I thought I was, like, standing next to him.
Okay, yeah, it's fine. That works. And,
So is he going to get, like, a raging boner over this?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Android boner.
I don't know how robo boners work.
You just have this thin metal rod.
My specification. Well, if our backstory was right, I'd be half sex droid. So I'm packing.
So you guys are, basically forced to come with them. You leave your ship. You know, it's still kind of smoking a little bit on the engine. Haven't fixed it.
I was going to get around to that, but then you see these natives here. Is that racist to call them natives? I don't want to be insensitive.
I'm not letting you anywhere near the engine.
Well, that's just plain old rude. I can fix an engine. I fixed my daddy's space tractor, I'll have you know.
Have Alex be the sound for the woman speaking broken English, because him doing a robot just sounds like broken English anyway.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he doesn't know what they're going to say, though.
That's true.
Yeah. But yeah, so you guys are forced to go into this very small village, right? Very, very simple huts. Smoke coming out of the chimney.
No, it's on fire!
Yeah. Okay. So, are you just gonna exclaim that, or are you gonna do something about it?
I'm gonna shout, "Oh no! It looks like it's on fire!" in all the languages that I know, which is barely one. And I'm going to.
Can I like? Did I hear any of their like? I heard their speaking before, right?
Yeah, they were speaking amongst themselves in their own language.
Don't we have that?
Can I roll to speak in that language?
Yeah. Go for it. Give me a feeling.
We have a translator thing.
Is it a feeling?
Yeah, it's a feeling.
Even though I'm a robot?
That's true. I mean, he's trying to build rapport with them, trying to learn the language.
So 1d6 then?
And you're a 4, so you gotta get above that. So, let's see.
Oh, whoops. Okay, well, never mind.
Give me one more, since you should be an expert in language.
Okay.
So yeah, as it turns out, these are a very very hardly studied tribe. There's only one expedition and of this this world, and only one of the team that, studied them and their language made it out alive. And so he had very broken knowledge. So you can understand maybe a third of what they're saying.
Sweet.
So
more than what's his face speaks in English.
So basically, they're looking at you, and then the one that kind of, you know, is, I guess, your guide now, beckons to you to come to a much larger, you know, hut.
What are the huts made of?
Wood.
Okay, yeah. So I have a plan. Can you start fires? All right.
Can I start fires? I assume, yeah.
Yeah.
No, that's not. Yeah.
I like that second one.
Okay.
It's not as easy as my D&D character.
So, here's the thing. This starts
secretly
going...
Secretly Gungeon in disguise.
This starts going poorly. You start a little fire up under their britches. And so, that way we can get all out of here and be all escaped.
You want me to light them on fire?
Well, more so the huts, because they'll probably won't put that out. I don't think they care about each other too much.
So, well, here's the thing. They're right next to you.
Well, she only understands a little bit of what I'm saying. I'm just going to, like, badmouth her and her whole tribe right in front of her and with a smile on my face and pretend like I'm complimenting them.
Okay, well, roll a feeling for me. See if they understand any of it. Okay, they understand. Not a goddamn word. the one that's, you know.
See, why can't he get these rolls in D&D?
I don't know. He's rolling pretty. He's fucked up my whole plan. I mean, at this point, I'm just making shit up. So,
like, we're all expecting more Naros rolls, and now he's rolling, like, fucking gudgeon with the fucking arrow.
Well, I mean, my rolls were atrocious when I was playing this, so.
Yeah, they really were.
They're pretty bad.
Space Costco was a clusterfuck.
Oh, God. Space Costco.
Costco's a clusterfuck anyway, so that's pretty accurate.
Well, Space Costco was even worse. Alright, so.
I mean, yeah, it's in space. You have more racism.
So basically, they don't hear you. Your guide was actually in that hut they were taking to, just kind of getting a bit more direction.
I'm going to turn to her and say, "You're very beautiful."
She understands that. She looks at you now, and she just shakes her head and then points her spear directly, you know, around your jugular area, and just says,
"Oh, when
me.
You said you know, I thought penis." Points
yeah,
it at the penis.
Point that a little lower, figured. And we'll have something to talk about.
Smooth.
Oh my God, I'm dying.
Okay, well, so you piss her off, and then she just slams the blunt end of the spear right into your balls.
Owie.
Oh, God.
Somewhat deserved.
And her two cronies, you know, they grab you by your shoulders, and the rest of them, you know, kind of push Alex forward.
I'm
they
in my chest!
They move you into the hut, right?
Is this our new house?
So in this hut, you see a completely naked woman. You know, she's kind of a little bit older, graying, right?
Does she have fur?
Huh?
Does she have fur?
No. I mean, yeah, in some places.
He gets a very confused boner.
So she's there. She's an older woman. She looks like, you know, the people look up to her. So you can only assume that she's their leader, right? She looks at you guys, you know, eyes serious. What the fuck are you doing here?
That was a swear word. You gotta donate to the swear jar. Mama would always smack me in the mouth unless I donated to the swear jar. I got a swear jar on the chip if you want me to go get it.
Why don't you
crash landed
this
our
kid
ship
sounds
on
like
your
the...
island.
This kid sounds like the fucking result of inbreeding.
I'm sure he was.
I'll have you know my daddy was inbred. I find that very offensive.
Inbreeding 101.
Tim, I want you to roll a feeling for me. I just want to see something.
You want to see if she fucking executes me?
She looks at you, right? She looks mad. She looks like in bed, like you, no one talks to her like that.
She looks livid, basically.
Yeah, but she keeps her composure. She's like, you. So what you're saying, you crash landed on my planet. And, you know, what makes you think we shouldn't just kill you here and scavenge your ship?
Well, how about this? There was this guy, I think his name was Zod, and he wanted us to go to this other place, and I'm pretty sure that it was like a treasure planet. And so we wanted to head there.
That's an amazing movie.
And what? I know, Space Treasure Planet was amazing. So we wanted to go there, and we'll make a deal with you. I will leave this very expensive space iPod with you. So as, like, I think it's called collateral. So I'll leave it here with you.
You just call me a space iPod.
Oh my god.
Is that what I am to you?
There's another t-shirt, guys.
Space iPod.
Is no, did you just call me a space iPod?
Oh my god.
Wow.
I'm gonna need a minute. My stomach hurts.
I'm still laughing because you're still laughing.
Oh my god.
God damn it.
So, don't interrupt me while the nice lady's talking, space iPod. So I'm gonna leave this very expensive space iPod with you as collateral. So that means, if you haven't been to our planet, it means I leave something expensive with you while I go to get something else expensive to give that to you so I can take my thing back. That way, everybody's happy. We won't go to this space treasure planet and bring back some very important treasure. I think there was, like, silver and gold and something called uranium-236. So, yeah. How about that?
My stomach legitimately hurts now.
Okay. Well, she's looking at you. She looks at some of her ladies, right? They're all looking right at you. And she's like, you're an idiot.
No. No. That is rude.
Mommy said I was special.
So here's the thing. Here's the thing. I'm not going to kill you because, as it turns out, I'm in need of help.
Help? Well, yeah. I know this great therapist back on Earth, and his name's Jared, so we could get you that help. He's a really good guy. He helped me a lot.
He's from this place called Subway.
No, not the Subway, Jared. He molested kids. That's not something we joke about.
We don't joke.
Am I like the voices in his head or something? Damn.
Yes.
What fourth wall?
So, she just looks at you, shakes her head. She's like, "No, not that kind of help. You fucking buffoon."
Hey, I love balloons.
She ignores you, please. She turns to Alex the android, and she's like, "Listen. We need help. As it turns out, I know that, you know, that person that you were talking about, his name is not Zod, it's Zorgon the Conqueror. He's feared throughout the galaxy, in this part of the galaxy, and he's turned his attention to our planet.
He's dead.
What?
He's dead.
It's my dad.
He's dead, and he's probably my dad. But we saw shit, like, fly right into him, start shooting laser beams at him, all like, pew, 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 and whatnot. So, yeah, we, like, saw him die. He is dead. I could go get you the body right now.
Well, are you sure about that? Are you 100% sure?
I am 100%.
Even if he isn't, Fred is a close friend.
I mean, because if you're not sure, I mean, then I don't need you, which means I'm going to kill you.
You know what? New plan? So, I'm pretty sure I hear him calling for me. I probably left a truck running again, so I'm going to go check on that.
You're in space more.
Space trucking.
So she looks at you. So that's what I thought. So you're going to help me.
Right? Yeah.
Because I can help you. Because I know on this planet there's a very old wreck.
Older than you?
And on that is something that I... There's something very, very valuable and very, very powerful that'd be a great asset to your ship. If you help me, I can help you and tell you where it is.
It's a new space iPod.
Is it going to be dangerous? Are there going to be furry creatures?
Lots of them.
Okay, we'll go.
Oh, God.
So basically, what has happened is that... Zorgon has been stealing my, you know, fellow tribe women for breeding.
Don't say another word. We'll do it purely based on that.
I'm in.
Oh.
One does not mistreat a lady. That is number one. That is what my daddy taught me. That is what his daddy before him taught him. So we'll do it. No questions asked.
Yeah, what Fred said.
Okay. Well, that's good.
So, did you say bread or Fred?
It's basically the same thing.
Same IQ.
Why do I always play idiots?
I don't know.
It's because it's your personality?
It's just, he's just kidding. Tim is... You're just typecasting yourself.
I love it. The voice is in his head.
In all of our heads.
I am Jesus.
So basically, she tells you that, you know, her people have been harvested by Zorgon.
Harvested like a plant?
No, you know, they've been kidnapped. And
did they get them planted for the new season in time?
One of her good people just smacks you.
Owie. Molly used to hit me like that. You remind me an awful lot like her.
Gets another boner.
Very confused boner.
Very confused. Very confused. So basically her proposition is that you need to retrieve them. You need to save them. And basically she gives you coordinates to a planet, and you're wondering, how does this crazy tribe of people have so many, you know, knowledge of where this other
so
planet
many
is?
So many knowledge.
I'm going to ask her exactly how she knows that.
Okay. Roll me a feeling.
In a moment of clairvoyance.
In the moment of him not being a complete fucking moron.
Wow. She trusts the shit out of you.
I'm going to say in like a proper British accent.
So basically she's telling you that she's not from this world. She crash landed here many years ago. And has been taken in by these people. And they, you know, voted her to the leader after a 2-week delegation.
Hey, expensive iPod. Doesn't that remind you of that time we crash landed here?
Uh, She's a space Republican.
God damn it.
Make space great again.
Is that like on the? That's gonna be on the side of your ship right there.
It is.
I'll have you know I voted for McCain 6 times.
6 times.
6 times. He only ran once.
That's a little thing in the biz we call cheating.
Oh, such a big word.
Business, were you in?
Who'd you ask that?
I asked that to Fred.
Oh, what did you ask?
What kind of business were you in?
Oh, you know that business where you play a bunch of card games on a TV?
No.
I think it was called Yu-Gi-Oh.
God damn it.
Oh, God.
You don't remember Space Yu-Gi-Oh Season 2?
No.
I'm an international, intergalactic celebrity.
Okay, Kaiba. Okay.
Yeah, Pegasus, calm down.
No.
I don't know. That's more Kaiba.
You were getting me confused. I was only in like 2 minutes of an episode. But I'm practically famous. Everybody here should know my face.
And she looks at you. Roll me a feeling.
Oh, God.
Here
She's
we go.
She's like not amused at all.
Well. She's like, you know what? I do remember that episode. I thought you were brilliant.
He's fucking up all of your plans.
All he has to do is roll higher than a 2 on any feeling check.
I know. It's like, I quit crash land you on this fucking backwater planet where no fucking science rules, laser rules can be rolled.
You know, maybe I could give you an autograph.
And
free of charge, just for nothing.
When you return.
Okay.
So you guys will do my task for me.
Yes, we will, absolutely, because it's time to What was that word, Space iPod?
Dual.
Thanks.
Okay. So she gives you the coordinates of the planet, which are in fact the same ones that old Zorgon gave to you, Big Daddy Z. And she tells you that if he's alive, as she feels he might be, since he's very, very resourceful, and as the bug that he is, doesn't die.
Oh, he's immortal.
No.
That's a big word for someone your size.
Dude. Yeah, the only reason...
your size. You're mixing games.
Big nope. Words for a little man.
Better not use that one on Gudgeon.
I know how I'm gonna piss Gudgeon off.
Just call him Gudgeon.
Yeah, just call me Gudgeon.
It's okay, you started doing that.
I started doing it just to piss him off.
You know, right?
You guys are fucking killing me.
Not like, as much as Space like, iPod.
Like lasers and feelings with the Three Stooges.
One of us isn't even playing.
Yeah.
He's the third stooge.
I am the third stooge.
And there's still only 3 of us. Hello, me, Cody, and Revlo. Not Revlo, Nightbot.
So you guys get back to your ship. But you still need to...
Someone said hello, Siri, by the way.
Yeah, I saw that, but it's too late for me to respond now. They're gone.
Yeah, Pikachu with the PS4. That's a good one. So you guys still need to fix the ship up.
Alright, I'm gonna roll for that.
Yeah, that'd be a laser. Let's see it.
While he's doing that, could I ask them if there's anything we could, like, borrow to fix our ship?
Sure. Roll me a laser.
A laser? I'm trying to convince them. I'm asking them heart to heart.
Oh, I thought you were using the ship scanner.
No. I'm not that sophisticated.
Oh, fucking roll me a feeling.
I don't know. You know some pretty big words.
Hang on. I gotta check one thing. One thing and one thing
only. Should I roll two for fixing the engine? Because I knew somewhat about repair.
Yeah, go ahead. Let's fuck it. Go for it.
At this point, the DM's just like,
just to get off the fucking planet.
I just want to move on with my story.
Wait. Oh. Yes.
Okay, ooh, I got a laser feeling.
You do get a laser feeling. And you get fours, you get a... So yeah, you found. If you... What were you rolling for, Alex?
Fixing the engine.
Yeah, you fix it like half the time. It's beautiful.
Sweet.
So, you want to use your question now?
So, where should we look to land on this next planet we're going to?
It's Zorgon's home planet.
Where?
And,
on that planet.
So, it's a very... Where you're going to be going is a huge city. So, just, you know, just land on one of the landing pads, but there will be a fee.
Oh shit, do we have space money?
We'll see.
I have a few space bucks lying around.
It's all in the roll of the dice. So yeah, you fixed the ship up, it looks great. In fact, you almost fixed the circuit breaker problem, but, you know, it's just always going to pester you.
I'd like to roll to fix the circuit breakers.
Oh, go for it, give me a laser. Let's see that one.
We're just all excited to see what he ends up doing. Oh my god.
Oh god, you did it. You did it.
Just give it to him just because he did it.
He did it. He did it. I mean, this is lasers and feelings, and he did it. You fixed the circuit breaker problem. And hallelujah, the light in the bathroom that hasn't been working for 6 space months comes back on.
So, tell us, how'd you fix it?
Well, I just switched the red wire with the green wire, and then I did this thing with the rubber band that my mama showed me back when I was like 6. And I just sort of, you know, pinched the wires together, and then I touched those wires with another wire, and then I duct taped them. So you see... So then I took this one wire and I just ripped it out because it was superfluous. So, you know, that's all I did.
And also, not only did you fix the bathroom light, but the ship's onboard computer lady comes aboard and says, "Hello. It's been a while."
No fur has no fucks with it. You can have this one, Space iPod.
You went from going
four legs, Fred.
You went from going to call him different names and just calling him Space iPod.
That just fucking killed me.
Oh god.
So real talk, I wasn't even like expecting to use him as that. I was talking about like an actual iPod. But then he said that.
I figured you were probably doing that, but I thought it was. Oh god,
that was good.
It's too much to pass up.
Space iPod, yeah. I'd like you to play me "What Is Love."
What is love, baby? Don't hurt me.
No, you need to be a robot.
A robot.
Robot.
I can actually put that song on for stream right now.
No, you asked Space iPod to do it. He's not really an iPod, so he has to sing it.
It's true.
Music collection uninstalling. 5, 4.
I punch 3. Him in the face as hard as I can.
He's a robot. He doesn't have a face.
1.
Roll me a feeling.
Sad thing is, being a farmer, there's not much I'm prepared for.
And you connect solidly, and he goes flying back into the wall.
You don't talk to me like that. You don't spout numbers. You're not a Russian machine.
Music gone.
Well,
you call him Russian.
You know, like a Russian number station.
Oh god, those weird, creepy things.
Yeah, I'm cultured. I came from Space Earth.
Space Earth.
I thought it was ER.
Well, I was on Earth before we did this. That's where I was a sex slave. But I originally lived on Space Earth.
And Alex is like over there just watching him talk to himself.
Well, since the ship is fixed, onboard computer's back, all you guys need to do is put the coordinates right into the system. And since you have the onboard computer now back up, you do it without even needing a roll. And you guys go zooming off to the Zorgon
zoom,
the
Conqueror. Zoom, zoom,
Zorgon actually, the Conqueror's planet.
So, from our ship going back up, do we see where, like, the impact would have been when that ship hit his or when it started blasting his? Like, do we know where that would be in relative terms to where we are?
Yeah. You could probably make a scan. I mean, you could, of it if you'd like.
I would like to scan. I would not like to scan. I want to use the Android scan feature. Android, that's your cue to scan.
Ship's computer, please scan.
Anything for you, sweetheart.
Robo wink. I don't have eyelids.
You know what? I want you to roll me a feeling for this one.
Shit!
Oh boy.
This me? Is gonna be awful.
Yeah.
Alright, one feeling. Let's take. Oh, wait, what? Oh,
what?
What? How did that even happen? What the fuck?
The power of love.
1d6 exclamation mark exclamation power mark gets a 10.
Alright, do you want me to roll like... Oh, whoops, I had fucking... I clicked... Somehow Shadowrun style got clicked on, and I guess I critted the roll.
Wow. So I'm gonna...
Here, hang on.
Yeah.
Just give it to him, damn.
So, well, so yeah, you do it. Coordination's in. You guys are... You know, the map of this part of the galaxy is somehow been entered into your computer. I mean, it's not very really
loves
been.
Me.
Yeah, and you guys zoom
someone
off
to
his planet. So, do you guys want to leave? Have this a to be continued?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, let's do that.
All
right. I was just starting to enjoy it.
No. The story makes no sense. I'm trying to cobble it back together. I love
it. He's literally fucked up everything.
I know.
You're welcome.
I was like, okay, what are we going to do? What happens? Okay. Tribe of Amazonia. I'm surprised your robot didn't, you know, try to...
I don't get a chance to do anything. Serivich is just rolling off quality lines that demand action.
I know.
It's amazing.
So I don't get a chance to do anything.
Oh, come on. Space iPod's probably the best thing of this show.
That was the best thing that has been said on this show.
It was pretty goddamn awesome. But yeah. So... If there's another need for lasers and feelings, we have a story to go to.
A quote-unquote story.
Yes. It's a story. And next time on
this
Zorgon...
This is a story all about how...
Zorgon the Conqueror fell in love.
Oh yeah, you better bet we're gonna get that fucking three-way.
I can't believe you rolled a 6 on those. I was like... You both rolled a 6. I was like, what the... What? Is this gonna happen?
I just wish you rolled like that during D&D. Yeah. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, but with D&D, there's a much greater range for fucking it up.
So much greater range. That's the beauty of lasers and feelings.
You either succeed or you don't.
Or you crit and get a 10. On a D6.
Like, you either somehow fail, you succeed, you really succeed, or you really, really succeed.
Damn. Alright, guys, I think that should do it for this weekend.
I've spoken too much with a southern accent for this week.
I know. You're fucked up. Well, you live in North Carolina, so I guess, maybe?
I live in South Carolina.
Oh, South. So there you go.
I don't want to miss the next lasers. If you guys do it some more, so save the lasers for me.
Well, that all depends on if someone's missing. I think this is our...
I can't do next weekend.
Oh, well, then we'll do a different story.
Yeah, do a different story, because I like this story.
Yeah, Josh will definitely be that DM, or whoever wants to, I don't know. Fuck it.
You fuck it, make I'll shit DM up. Next time.
There you go.
Unless Alex wants to.
No, I'm good.
No.
Alright, well, see you guys later.
Alright.
Yep, see ya.
Bye.
Yeah.